is when performance meets power. You try crazy things because you're crazy and you like it. You spend unhealthy amounts of manpower creating ungodly amounts of horsepower. You get bigger, badder, faster. You can never have too much of a good thing. And power is a very good thing.
Hi everybody, this is Rat Hulkat back at you again with another cool video. Today in New Jersey, it's another nice, beautiful spring day. Not a cloud in the sky. Blue skies, very sunny out, no clouds in the sky. Beautiful weather. It's a little bit chilly, but the sun is shining on me. I'm feeling warm. I may not even need the hoodie right now. I'm wearing the Dodge Hellcat Red Eye Hoodie. Yes, the Dodge Hellcat Red Eye Hoodie. You gotta love the Dodge Hellcat Red Eye Hoodie. And that's what I'm wearing today, even though I could probably take it off after this video is over, but I gotta represent. And we also have the 2021 Dodge Durango Hellcat in the driveway as well. So we're representing today. Hopefully you're representing Dodge and representing it well. So without further ado, let's get started because this is another Rad Hulkat walk around. Yes, Rad Hulkat walk around. And today's video is going to be somewhat different because, as you all know, originally I was planning to put up the Jeep Grand Cherokee Trackhawk video, which is still in the editing room, by the way. But I just realized that the guys at this dealership really wanted me to promote the Dodge Challengers first because they're still available for sale. So we are now going to travel to another dealership that I have built a great relationship with. It's Sansone Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram in Avenel, New Jersey. Shout out to Eli, shout out to Trey, shout out to Angie, and shout out to Patrick. Those are my new friends at Sansone Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram. In this video, it's not just one, it is two Dodge Challenger Hellcats that were just freshly built in the month of December. They are still available at the dealership for sale. And if you're interested in buying any of the two that I have in this video, I'll put the contact information in the description and below the screen right here. Again, Eli is the general manager. And then the three sales reps that I want to promote are Trey, Angie, and Patrick. Definitely reach out to any one of the three of them. I'm sure they would appreciate it because we have two Dodge Challenger Hellcats for sale. It's gonna be a great walk around just to go over all of the options and the features of these cars. But in addition to that, these are still available for sale. So without further ado, enough of me talking, let's get into the video. Let's get into the walk around of the 2021 Dodge Challenger Hellcats. And at the end of the video, I'll be back with you with final thoughts and all of the information that you need to buy these two wonderful Dodge Challenger Hellcats. So again, let's get to the video. I'll be back with you again with final thoughts. Enjoy the video. Okay, we have another RAL Hellcat walk-arounds. This time, we have not just one Challenger Hellcat, but we have two Challenger Hellcats. And we almost had three Challenger Hellcats, but that one just drove away. So we're going to have to settle for this, just these two. So we are at Sansone Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram in Avenel, New Jersey. Shout out to Eli, who allowed me to film this today. He's one of the managers. I really do appreciate that. Today we're going to take a look at two 2021 Dodge Challenger Hellcats. One's in pitch black. The other one is in smoke show. We're going to go over all of the options, all the cool features, the pricing, and believe it or not, even though we're in the showroom, they even said we could start it, which is going to be interesting. I've never started a vehicle inside the showroom, but we're not going to take advantage and have it run the whole time, but we will do the start. We're going to do a cold start inside the showroom. So We're going to do a brief walk around of the two vehicles. Again, these are 2021s. They were just built. In fact, we're going to check the dates in a moment. I believe they were built in December. This is the Rahal Cat walk around, December 2021 edition of the last of the 21s. So in continuation of the last of the Durango Hellcats, we also have the final builds of the Challenger Hellcat. So let's get into it. We're going to finish our walk around, and then we're going to take a look at the date in which each one was built. And then we're going to go over all the options. We have two of them to review. We're going to do this all in one video. So bear with me. We're going to get this done pretty quick. Again, we're at Sansone Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram in Avenel, New Jersey. So without further ado, let's get started. Let's take a look first on the black one. The black one always catches my eye here. Also, it has the brass monkey rims with red calipers. So it's got the standard red calipers, but it obviously has the brass monkey package. It's got the brass monkey Hellcat badge on the sides. It also has the brass monkey Hellcat badges in the front. And because it also has the performance spoiler in the back, there is no brass monkey badge, but if it didn't have that, it had the standard spoiler, it would definitely have the Hellcat badge. It does have the performance spoiler. I don't know why they couldn't fit the Hellcat badges on the back. At least the blackened out Dodge lettering, which is different than what we are going to see on the smoke show. But first and foremost, let's get into when was this built. In fact, we're going to look at both of when they were built. So this one was built in December. Yes, another December build, December 13th. Yep, there it is, December 2021, and it was built on December 13th. So this is definitely one of the December builds. Just for the sake of argument, before we get into the smoke show one and see if this is built before or after or right next to. So this was built in, this is built in November. This is a November build. All right, so our first November build. So November 21, November 15th. This is when this is built, November 15th. So we have a December build. We have a November build, but we already started with the black one. So let's get into the black one here. Go over the options. The window sticker is right here, loose for me to grab. So let's do that first. We'll take a seat inside, take a look at the Uconnect, all that good stuff. See if it has navigation set up. All right, so we have a 2021 Dodge Challenger Hellcat in pitch black. It's got the black Laguna leather interior. There's all your standard equipment, but you know, we want to see all the options. Again, they all start at $61,150. It sounds pretty cheap, but you got to think about what you're getting for $61,150. That starts off with the cloth seats. That's why it's so inexpensive. But then we had our options. So our first option is the plus package. This bumps you up to the Alcantara seats, ventilated front seats, premium stitch dash panel, the power tilt steering, and the dark engine turn interior accents. Then we have the driver convenience group, blind spot monitoring, cross path detection, high intensity discharge headlamps, power multifunction mirrors with manual fold away for $1,295. So if I didn't mention this before, the plus package is $2,095. The driver convenience group is $1,295. And then of course, because I said before Alcantara, if you didn't get this next package, then you would have the Alcantara seats. But because this has the Laguna leather package for $1,795, that bumps you up to the nice Laguna leather. This is not Red Laguna. These do have the demonic red seatbelts, which is interesting because the demonic red seatbelts are $395, but if you were to get the demonic red leather, that's also $395. Pretty drastic option choice for the same price. If it were up to me, you know, I love black interiors and I love red seatbelts, but if for the same $395, I would get the red interior with the black. So, and that's what we were going to have. Like if we were going to look at the a car that was here, it was a wide body Hellcat Challenger that's not here. I missed it. It had the demonic red interior wide body package. It drove out of the showroom right before I showed up. Maybe, well, they said about 3 hours. So nonetheless, let's keep going. We have the automatic transmission, which is $29.95.
Power Sunroof, which is $19.95. The Performance Spoiler, which I mentioned before, $9.95. And the Brass Monkey Package, which is $1,095, which includes the Brass Monkey rims, Brass Monkey badges, and then the black satin tail lamp badge for the back. Gas guzzler tax, destination charge brings you to a total of $77,105. So, let me do this. Let me put the window sticker back on the dashboard. Let's look at some of the cool things inside. In fact, cool things inside. So we have, it's really nice inside. We have the sunroof, so it's letting all the light in. You have the leather wrapped dash, which is again part of that plus package. It's only got 6 miles on it. In fact, I had it open for a minute there. Let's see. Let's open it up again. Yeah, it's only got 6 miles on it. In fact, I have the keys, so I could actually light this bad boy up. So let's light it up. Let's light this candle. Put it on run. Did they not have the screen on? Let's put it on. Oh, there you go. Turn on the screen, hit accept. Let's close the door so it doesn't keep beeping. All right, so we are good to go. So again, this has the Laguna leather seats. It has the embossed Hellcat logo versus the embroidered that I have in my Durango Hellcat, but I had these exact same seats for when I had my Charger Hellcat. The only thing I didn't have were the red seat belts. We're going to take a look at those in just a second. So you have your silver contrast stitching in the seats. The seats are very comfortable and very intoxicating as far as the smell. That's very cool, very nice. You also have, in fact, let me just turn this off for 1 second. I want to do the door panel real quick. On the door panel, you also have the silver contrast stitching on the door panel, which is really nice. Again, it's part of the plus package. You also have cup holder, and it's got the Alpine stereo. So it has the Alpine stereo system as opposed to the Harman Kardon. The Harman Kardon is your only optional stereo system. The Alpine, believe it or not, is standard in the Challenger Hellcat. So Alpine is standard. Also, what you have, let me close the door real quick, and we're gonna turn this bad boy on one more time. This is pretty cool when you get to see this. You get the Hellcat logo, you get the red gauges. I love the Challenger gauges as opposed to the Charger gauges. Just saying. It's got 200 on the dash because this is a regular Hellcat. It's not a red eye. It's not a super stock and it's not a jailbreak. Those would have the 220 on the dash. This has the 200. So still pretty cool, pretty nice as we keep hearing the beeps. So let's go over what we have here in terms of options. It's got the Uconnect 4 system, which again, I'm going to zonk it because I think that, well, actually I won't zonk it because 2021s, it's understandable if it has the Uconnect 4, but I'm going to zonk the 2022s because the 2022s should really have the Uconnect 5x9. And if you were going to get a 2022 Challenger Hellcat, that will also have the Uconnect 4. Unlike my Durango Hellcat in 2021 has Uconnect 5, and I absolutely love it. So let's see what else it has. Now, I don't believe this thing has navigation. Let's go through some of the options here. Let's go through all the apps. So if it did have navigation, that probably would have been one of the controls. So you have climate, you have the seat controls. So the climate down here, climate is off because we don't have the car on and we're not going to turn it on right now. We have the controls here for your heated and ventilated seats, heated steering wheel, very standard stuff for having the Laguna leather or the suede interior. The only time you wouldn't have cooled seats is if you went with the cloth. You have all your apps. If you go through all your apps here, these are all the standard apps. Again, it'll have everything but navigation at this point. We've already seen this once before. Then you have your performance pages. It should say 717 horsepower because we're going to see the Hellcat engine in 1 second. Okay, so you have your performance pages. You have your power, current gear, G-force. You have your timers. You have your drag settings here, recent, last, and best. You have your gauges. oil temp, oil pressure, coolant temp, battery voltage, trans temp, boost pressure, air fuel ratio, coolant temperature, and the last page is your intake air temp. Exact same options that I have currently on both my Trackhawk and my Durango Hellcat, as well as when I had my Charger Hellcat. You have your G-force monitor with braking left and right and acceleration. You have your engine diagnostics, your horsepower, torque, and your pounds per square inch on the supercharger. And of course, when the engine is running, you have your dyno. Pretty basic stuff. This is standard on all Hellcats, but I figured this is a more impromptu review because we do have the keys and we're able to show you this. Anytime I'm able to show this to you, I'm going to do it. But I'm not going to do it on the smoke show one, but I'm going to definitely do it on this one because we're combining the two walk-arounds and reviews here. So this also does not have the suede, and this also does not have the carbon fiber and suede package, but that's okay. But I think that the standard Hellcat console trim and dash trim, I like this. It actually gives it a step up from, say, the Scat Pack or even the other Challengers that you would have available to, say, like the RT, the SXT, the GT. Does not have this almost, I guess it's not a houndstooth, but it's definitely a design that makes it look a little bit more upscale. And the only difference between this and the carbon fiber is the carbon fiber will have genuine carbon fiber and also be more darkened and blacked out. So let's keep going. Let's keep going. We also have here a center console. Center console is pretty cool. It's got your USBs and it's got your charging port. It also has this Easter egg from the Dodge Brothers. We've seen this once before. And because it's getting pretty warm in here, because it is a warm, sunny day, I'm going to go and take a break outside. But actually, let me just show you the hard buttons first. Before we do that, we have the mute button, screen off, which is the way it was set up when I turned it on. We have SRT pages. So if you want to hit the SRT pages, it actually takes you real quick to the SRT pages as opposed to hitting the performance pages here. You also have a launch control, which is only available to you at 500 miles. You have parking sensors, a stability control, which is pretty standard now. And then you also have your climate controls, both on the passenger and the driver's side. Also front and rear defrosters, AC and recirculation. And again, like I said before, this has the 8-speed ZF transmission with manual controls. If you can either do automatic or manual, along with the paddle shifters. This does not have adaptive cruise control. So this is the standard cruise control. And these buttons here would be for the adaptive cruise control, but doesn't have that. Okay. So let's turn it off real quick because we're going to be able to start this in a moment. But for right now, what I'm going to do next is it's going to take you for a quick tour of the inside from the outside. So again, it's got your Laguna leather seats with the embossed Hellcat logo. It's got the demonic red seat belts, which I think are really, really cool. It also carries over into the back seat. We're not going to go in the back seat because we've already done this a number of times, but it's really cool that it's got the contrast of the demonic red seats in the back with the black Laguna. Really cool, really nice. I mean, I tell you, this for me, this spec, I love everything about this spec. If it were a wide body, I definitely would consider it. So in addition to that, like I said before, we have the red calipers that I had mentioned before, the brass monkey rims, the brass monkey Hellcat badges, and of course the blackened Dodge lettering on the back of this gorgeous 21 Dodge Challenger Hellcat, built in December, one of the last 2021s to be built. What we're going to do next is, before we do the final piece de resistance, which you know is viewing the Hellcat engine compartment, we're now going to dive into the smoke show one. So let's do that now. Okay, so now we're going to take a look at the smoke show. And the smoke show is different in that it's got different rims. It's almost got those matte vapor rims that I have. It's the 5-spoke rims that my Charger Hellcat had, except these are black versus the gunmetal. does have the red calipers. I'm so glad they kept the red calipers and not spend the extra money on black or gunmetal calipers. They could have gone orange since it is smoke show. I think you could have gone orange on either one. You had smoke show, which I think orange calipers could go well with the smoke show. And then I think with the brass monkeys, the orange calipers would have really gone well with that as well. As we keep walking around here, this is going to have your standard chrome Hellcat badge on the sides here. Again, this also has the performance spoiler. And it's going to have no Hellcat logo in the back, but it is going to have the chrome Dodge letters as opposed to the blackened Dodge letters on the black with the brass monkey package. This doesn't have that, so it's going to have your standard Dodge lettering. Again, it's going to have your black five-spoke rims with red calipers on both sides. Why would it have it different on either side? I have no idea. You have your chrome Hellcat badge on the passenger side as well. And then, of course, you have your chrome Hellcat badge in the front, which to me, if you were looking from a distance, I just think that the chrome badge just pops better. I think that's something I'm going to do with my Durango Hellcat. I think it just really pops better when it's chrome versus the blacked out or the glass monkey. So let's dive into the options. The window sticker happens to be on this other, the other side here. So we could do that. We have the keys in case it's locked. Oh, it looks like it's unlocked. Well, look, obviously the interior looks almost identical. I think the spec on these are almost identical. It's got the black Laguna leather. It's got your demonic red seatbelts. So that looks good. Looks nice. Let's take a look at those in the back. Again, the contrast is really cool. Same as the black one. Also has the Alpine stereo. Also has the Hellcat badge on the dash. Also has a sunroof. So I think these were optioned out very much the same. Let's see. What else does it have? Let's take a look. Take a look at the option list here. Okay, so 21 Dodge Challenger Hellcat, again, $61,150. All your standard options that we just went over, and now here are your options on this side. So it's got the same plus package at $2,095, driver's convenience group at $1,295. It upgrades you from the cloth seats to the Alcantara seats, but then you dip into the next option here, which is the Laguna leather package for $1,795, the demonic red seat belts for $395, the same Torque Flight ZF 8-speed automatic transmission for $29.95. Power sunroof. Your performance spoiler. Your gas guzzler tax and your destination charge. This one is $76,010 as opposed to the other one, which is $77,105. And the only difference between the smoke show and the black is the brass monkey package. So we can take a look at the interior real quick. We have the keys to it. We have the keys. We can take a look to see if there's anything else. If there's anything else to look at, let's take a look here. Okay, so this one's got 7 miles on the odometer, so these have literally not been driven. In fact, I'm really disappointed I didn't get to see the wide body because that was sitting right there. And it probably had no miles on either. So these, all three of them were in the showroom. I actually appreciate when dealership put them in the showroom, especially if you're looking to buy one of these. Sansone will keep them from being driven only because you want to buy a vehicle without any demo miles on it. So let's start. I'm not going to start it just yet. Close the door real quick so it stops beeping. And it's going to have the exact same setup. This does not have navigation. So again, it's going to have the same controls, your media, climate, seats, apps, phone, settings. We didn't go through settings, but settings are the same. If you want to look at some other Hellcat review videos, I have tons and tons of review videos that goes over all of the options and settings. This one actually has the Uconnect here. The performance pages are not popping up. Performance pages are not popping up. Or I can hit the SRT button. And the SRT button will take me to the same spot. We didn't demo that before. We just demo that now. So you have that. Also, you have your shift. I didn't see this before. We didn't go over this, but this is got your shift lights. Your line lock is in here. That's what's really cool about these. 2019 and up had line lock. I wish the 2018 I had line lock. It was so hard to do burnouts when you have the rear brakes downed up, because what line lock does is it turns the front brakes on and turns the rear brakes off, making it easier to do a burnout. So you have your performance pages again. Same thing that we just showed you before, which I just did with the black one. So we don't have to see that again. The other thing I wanted to do real quick, hold on, let's go back to home. Let's go back to SRT dashboard. So you got performance pages, drive modes, drive mode. So this is something we didn't see in the black one because we skipped it, but you have the track mode. Track mode, sport, custom. And what custom allows you to do is, because in track mode, these options here, traction, suspension, and steering can only be in track mode. In sport mode, the traction, suspension, and steering can only be in sport mode. But what's nice about custom mode is that you can change your traction, suspension, and steering. You can change the traction. Well, we'll keep... we'll do traction on sport, we'll do suspension on street, and we'll put steering in track. We couldn't do that in the sport specific mode, the track specific mode. We could only do that with the custom mode. Now, this does have 717 horsepower, but I have black keys. They didn't give me red keys, but that's okay. We're not driving anywhere, so that's something we don't have to see. So again, it's going to have your same standard set up on the console, which again, there's nothing to say negative about that. I like the fact that it's got the leather wrapped dash and the leather wrapped on the door panels, because it doesn't have that alligator skin. It doesn't have the soft suede headliner or the carbon fiber package. I believe it's another $1,500. So you're saving that much money on that, and it gives you money to spend on the sunroof, which I really would. I mean, people don't appreciate a sunroof until it's like really warm out like it is today. And you can actually pop it open and have it open a crack like I do with mine. So it's really cool, really nice. So I think we've done enough on the interior of this one. Let's turn this off real quick. We're going to swing around again on the driver's side. Give you an idea of what the Hellcat logo again is embossed versus stitch. We have the silver contrast stitching on the black Laguna leather, as well as silver contrast stitching on the door panels. And if I didn't already mention it before, this does have the Alpine stereo. The trunks are pretty much the same on both cars. We could pop the trunks on both. You know, I haven't seen one without the Harman Kardon in a while, so I'm curious to see what's under here. And yes, it's exactly what I expected. So it's got the battery, it's the tire inflation kit. It does not have the Harman Kardon subwoofer. And that's where you would see it in a Challenger. It's got a lot of room back here. In fact, the room in a Challenger Hellcat is only within 1 cubic feet less than in a Charger. That's a fun fact. Both split fold-down rear seats. So you get that in both the Challenger and the Charger. And the same thing is going to be true about the black one. There's not going to be any difference here with the black. So you're going to have the same setup back here. You have all these cool manuals. Here are your pedals. I already know what that's in that box. You have the front license plate holder, which you would never use. And again, underneath you have the same setup where it's the air inflation kit, a little bit of storage, and your battery. All right. What are we gonna do first? We're gonna do piece de resistance. We're gonna do the piece de resistance. And that is, yes, boys and girls, you heard it. It's gonna be double Hellcat engine. We got two Hellcats here, why not? We're gonna pop the hood on the smoke show. I'll swing around here and pop the hood on the pitch black Challenger Hellcat. And you know what we talk about over and over again? This is the piece de resistance in any Hellcat walk around and review, and that is, yes, boys and girls, we have
Hellcat engine number one. Let's swing around over here and do the second one. Oh yeah, this is gonna be cool. I got it. Ooh, here we go. Okay, piece de resistance time. Hellcat engines. Hellcat engines. We have not just one, but we have two Hellcat engines. Again, you heard me say this once, you've heard me say it a million times. This is 6.2 liter supercharged Hemi V8, 717 horsepower in the Challenger, base Challenger Hellcat, 656 pound-feet of torque. It also has the standard cold air intake box with functional hood scoop. It's got the functional hood scoop, which gives you that extra 10 horsepower, because typically when these Hellcats first came out, they had a closed air intake, 707 horsepower, but now with the extra air that's going into the engine, they bumped it up, gave it a 10 horsepower tune, which allowed it for the 717 horsepower. So again, 717 horsepower, 656 pound feet of torque, Hellcat power. Get you some of that. Let's go over, because if it's nothing better than seeing one Hellcat engine, it's seeing two. Again, same thing. 717 horsepower, 656 pound feet of torque, 6.2 liter supercharged Hemi V8. I can never get enough of reviewing the Hellcat engine. These are days are numbered, years are numbered. We only have two more years left of these. The 21 Hellcat Durango is gone. The Jeep Grand Cherokee Trackhawk is gone. The TRX still lives. And we don't know how many more years that's gonna live. But we do know that the Challenger and Charger Hellcats, this is a 21, they only have 2022 and 2023 left. Yeah, boys and girls, this is one of those things where we are at the very end of life here with the Dodge Challenger and Charger Hellcat, but we can never get enough of looking at this. Again, one more time, before I close the hoods, 6.2 liter, supercharged. And this is the 2.4 liter supercharger as opposed to the 2.7 liter supercharger you would find in the Red Eye, the Demon, and Superstock, and the Jailbreak. This is the original 2.4 liter supercharger that'll give you the 717 horsepower, 656 pound-feet of torque. Get you some of that. Cold air intake, like I said before, this is functional. It's functional because these hood scoops, this is now the 2019 version of the hood. This is the Hellcat hood that was introduced in 2019 that has functional hood scoops. This one's functional. It funnels on this side, travels over to the opening that you see here with your Hellcat Easter egg, comes through here, seals to this air box, sucks in air from the top of the hood into the air box. It also you have an open headlight on the driver's side that also sucks in air and goes into this air box as well. So there's two ways that air will get into this air box. Also, because it's the open version of the intake, it also gives you that glorious supercharger one that you get stock from the factory without having to go aftermarket with a cold air intake like it did on the Charger Hellcat and the Durango Hellcat and the Trackhawk. This is an open air box, so you're gonna hear the glorious whine loud as hell in the Challenger Hellcat stock from the factory. Now this, of course, is still sealed up. In fact, if I take my hand and it still has that piece of plastic back there, but hopefully someday that'll be removed by whoever owns this, and that'll just let more air get into the engine bay to help cooling. It's not gonna contribute for the air that goes directly into the air box. I would only recommend you did that, only recommend you drive it not in the rain, because I believe they have this sealed off because they don't want rain to get into this area here where you have all this electronics. So again, we go over this over and over and over again. This is the last time for today, at least, that you're gonna see this Hellcat engine. So what I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna close the hood on the smoke show. I'm now gonna go over to the black, pitch black. We're gonna say goodbye to this glorious Hellcat engine. Oh yeah, can't get enough of it. Look at that Hellcat logo, gotta love it. Same thing, same setup. Air intake here,
Hellcat Easter Egg here, cold air intake here, 717 horsepower, 656 pound-feet of torque. Get you some of that. We're gonna close the hood. And now, you thought the piece de resistance was just seeing the two Hellcats side by side with the Hellcat engines? No, we're gonna do one more thing. We're gonna do cold starts. We got permission to do that. We're gonna do a cold start of each one. Let's walk around real quick. In fact, let's just do it in the middle. I got the keys with me. They said I could do it, and now we're gonna do it. This is the last thing we're gonna do before this review is over. Piece of resistance time, Hellcat. Let's see, which one we got in my hand here? We have the smoke show in my hand, and we have the other one in my hand. Let's take a look. And this one's the black one. All right, so we're gonna start the smoke show first. This is gonna be great. There's not many people in the showroom, so they're not gonna be disturbed here. We have the one customer over there, but hopefully, if anything, this might help sell both of these cars. So let's do smoke show cold start. Open on this one. Let's see. All right, let's turn this off because we don't want to abuse the privilege. But you got the chance to listen to the smoke show one. All right, so that's smoke show. Let's see if we can't get this black one to start. But the only thing I can think of as to why it didn't start is if the doors are still open. No, that door's closed. Trunk's closed. Okay, that door's closed. This should work. So we should have the right key here. And this is the black one. Let's do it. Oh, yeah, this will start. Ah, the battery's dead. That's why it didn't start. Okay. Battery's dead. We have to let them know. That's fine. Well, at least they know now. All right? So we have to do this one more time. So let's do the smoke show one because we didn't get a double cold start. We're going to do this one real quick. And this way I can review a little bit better for you. All right. So the one built in November starts up. So you have your vacuum cleaner, exhaust tips here and here. And it does sound glorious. We'll let this run for 30 more seconds and then we'll call this a review. So obviously the black one, the battery's dead. We apologize for that, but at least they know now that it's dead. Hope you enjoyed this. Without further ado, we were gonna turn this bad boy off. All right, that is something really cool. I never did that before inside a dealership, but they have the doors open, so hopefully that's okay with them. Let's put these keys back in my pocket so that we don't lose them. All right. Okay, so we're gonna do the final walk around to close out this video. Again, if you're interested in either one of these 2021 Dodge Challenger Hellcats, in either pitch black or smoke show, come see us at Sansone Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram in Avenel, New Jersey. Ask for Eli Jimenez. He'll hook you up. Obviously, I just met him today, and he allowed me to do this fantastic, not only the fantastic review for you, but I actually have the keys and was actually able to do a cold start inside the showroom, which, again, I was reluctant to do, but they said it was okay to do. We sorry we couldn't get the black one to start up, but you know, they're gonna sound the same. They do need to charge that battery, so we will let them know that. This is Rao Hellcat signing off. And you know what we always do at the end of these videos, we're going to talk about this a little bit more in final thoughts, but with all that being said, please, if you're interested in either one of these beautiful 2021 Dodge Challenger Hellcats, again, smoke show, pitch black. Options are basically the same, except the black one has the brass monkey package. All I can say is shout out to Sansone Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram in Avenel, New Jersey. Make sure you contact Eli Jimenez. He will definitely take care of you if you're interested in either one of these. And with all that being said, this video is not coming to a close. And if I didn't say so already, we will put the description of each vehicle in my description and comment section. The window sticker link will be on the YouTube channel description. So definitely look these vehicles up. Then give Eli a call. He'll then hook you up with a sales rep who will then sell you one of these badass Dodge Challenger Hellcats. So with all that being said, I'll see you in the driveway with final thoughts, but we're going to say goodbye now to these two wonderful Hellcats. I'll see you in the driveway. Final thoughts time in 1, 2, 3. Peace. Final thoughts time. See you in the driveway. If you look, so I got this all customized. So I got the leg maker cold air intake, and it's cold air because it's carbon fiber. I can put my hand on and not burn myself. It increases the whine. I got Billa Technologies oil catch can. I got more Billa Technologies that crunk, but really, I like the satin finish. Yeah, I think it sets off the supercharger really nice. I got certain things in here, like supercharged here, 6.2 liter here. And then the 707, I got that specially engraved. Yeah. It's a little bit dirty for me. I usually keep it a lot cleaner, but once the summer rolls around, spring, I'll be cleaning this up. That leg maker put on. It's LMI, is the company. Leg makers can pull their intake. They engrave that specific tube. It keeps the water from, because it's cold air, so it's got an open filter. And to protect it from the water, it that protects it from getting wet. So what do you think?
Beautiful.
Yeah. Beautiful. Thanks. I love this thing. And then when I show you the Durango Hellcat is almost finished.
Did that too custom?
Yep. That's also Billa Technology on the seat.
You only have 11,000 miles on this car?
Yeah, only 11,000.
Oh.
Yeah, I bought this in 2019 as a leftover on film. So let me rev it again for you guys. We're at Sansone Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram in Avondale, New Jersey. There's Eli right there. The guy that I was talking about before, Eli. I forget your name. So.
Hablo español.
Oh, okay. There you go.
Trey.
How you doing? I'm Angie.
All right, Angie. Hey, we got the whole crew here. This is awesome. A lot more than I expected as far as the welcome committee. So.
We love it. Like
so that. This is part of the video, guys. So whenever I put a car on my YouTube channel and shout all these guys out, give me your business cards as well. Put it in the description. And yeah, so.
And you have some business to talk about as well.
We do?
Yes, because we're going to be having a big event here in the summer.
Yeah, so I was just being told that. All right. Yes. I will definitely be a part of that. I don't know if I'll be able to bring both of them, but you make a choice.
You're definitely going to want to bring both of them.
All right. We'll see what happens. Let me just turn this off real quick.
I conserve on gas.
Oh, now we can hear each other.
Yeah, right?
So I had a Charger Hellcat. I did the exact same mods on that. But I took them all off to trade it in. And my Durango Hellcat now has the same Borla Attack system. I was the first person in the United States to put the Borla Attack full cat-back exhaust on a Durango Hellcat. So. Oh, this is dirty. This is not clean. For me, this is dirty.
He wants to go for a test drive.
You want to go for a test drive?
No, I'll wait for mine. Can wait.
All right. I'll take you for a ride eventually. If not today, we'll pick a day where we can.
The color that I actually wanted, though. Black.
I love this color. It's the metallic black as opposed to the pitch black. The diamond crystal black is freaking awesome. So, all right, we're going to close the video here. Again, thank you, guys. Sansone, Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram, awesome crew. Definitely like, subscribe, follow, and we'll meet you in the driveway with final thoughts. Thanks again, guys. Well, I hope you enjoyed the video of the walk around, the RAL Hellcat walk around of 2021 Dodge Challenger Hellcats. Yes, the Dodge Challenger Hellcats. Hope you enjoyed it. And now we're going to talk about it more in one of my favorite segments and one of your favorite segments, and that is final thoughts time. Yes, final thoughts time. Okay, final thoughts time. So, yes, the 2021 Dodge Challenger Hellcats that we saw are simply awesome, fantastic. And not just one, but two. Awesome. Last one's built
in the month of December. Last ones built in 2021. 2021 Dodge Challenger Hellcats. And why is this so significant? Why did we put these videos up knowing that we're right in the middle of the 2022 model year? Well, 2022s are still being built. 2022s have yet to hit dealerships as dealer stock. Most of the 2022s that have been coming in are customer orders. They're getting built first. So customers place their orders in the month of December when the order banks opened up. And then, of course, they're now being built starting in January. They started getting built. And as they were getting built, they're getting delivered. So as soon as they are built, they're getting delivered to the dealership, and then they're getting picked up by these customers. So we have yet to see, at least in the area that I live in, New Jersey, Pennsylvania, and New York area, I have yet to see anything locally by me that's a 2022 Dodge Challenger Hellcat that is for sale, available as a dealer inventory vehicle versus a sold vehicle. So the good news is, that if you haven't already placed an order and you're looking to get a Dodge Challenger Hellcat and you don't want to wait, you want to place the order, but you don't want to wait 5-6 months that it's going to take to build it, well, you're in for a treat, because these two vehicles, these two Dodge Challenger Hellcats, are available today. We have the Smoke Show, we have the Pitch Black. Both of them are available at Sansone, Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram in Avenel, New Jersey. Yes, I'm gonna shout you guys out one by one, so let's get going, let's get started. Let me do that right now, and we'll talk about these two wonderful vehicles. So again, we have Eli Jimenez. Eli Jimenez is the general manager at Sansone Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram. If you want a good deal, you want a great deal, as a matter of fact, reach out to Eli. He'll hook you up, and then, of course, he'll recommend one of his sales reps. But if you want to go in knowing that you have a sales rep that Rat Hellcat recommends, we have Trey Alexander. I'm going to put his information on the bottom here. Trey Alexander, awesome dude. He sits in the front. He actually is in a great spot, and would love to see you walk in the doors and take delivery of one of these two wonderful Dodge Challenger Hellcats. We also have Angie Calderon. Angie, how you doing, Angie? She knows me well, and definitely was looking forward to having her name shouted out in my video. So Angie, I'm shouting out right now, Angie Calderon. Her information is now on the bottom. Definitely reach out to Angie. And then last but not least is Patrick Sadowski. Patrick Sadowski. His information's on the bottom. May not pronounce it that great, but definitely reach out to Patrick. So we have Eli as the general manager, and then you have Trey, you have Angie, and you have Patrick to choose from. Any one of those great salespeople will be able to help you get these two wonderful Dodge Challenger Hellcats. Next, I just want to briefly go over the features. These were pretty well equipped. One was in Smoke Show, one was black. Both spec'd out about the same. They both had the Laguna leather. They both had the Harman Kardon, so they both had sunroofs. The only big difference between the two vehicles is that the black one had the brass monkey package. Yes, the brass monkey package was really cool. Has the brass monkey badges on the sides, the brass monkey Hellcat baggage, brass monkey in the front, brass monkey Hellcat badge in the back, and of course the brass monkey rims. So if you're looking for a brass monkey and you're looking for black, which I think is a great color combination, definitely go with the black Challenger Hellcat. And if you want to go with the standard rims with red calipers, you can go definitely with, you can't lose with the Smoke Show. Smoke Show, black interior, absolutely fantastic. Both vehicles are fantastic. And the best part about these two, because I could go on and on and on about these vehicles, but if you want to know more about them, rewatch the walk around. Because the walk around, we went over all the options and we went over all the pricing. So definitely. And then we put the window sticker in the description as well, so you can take a look at the options in case you didn't get a chance to while watching the video. So you know both vehicles, you know who to call. So you want to keep the final thoughts short. And with all that being said, those are my final thoughts. This video is now coming to a close. I hope you enjoyed. If you did enjoy the video, please give it a thumbs up. I truly do appreciate it. Also, put a comment or two. Do you like the Dodge Challenger Hellcat? Do you have a Dodge Challenger Hellcat? Are you looking to get a Dodge Challenger Hellcat? Are you looking to get maybe a 2022? Get a red eye, get a jailbreak? Or if you're willing to go with just something that's just your basic Hellcat, your standard Hellcat, narrow body, these two are available right now. So definitely put in a comment, let me know what your thoughts are. And you know, I always respond to each and every one of my comments. I look forward to hearing your comments, and I look forward to responding. Also, share the video with everyone you know. Share the video with everyone you know. Share this video for anyone that you know that is interested in getting a Dodge Challenger Hellcat. They want to get a Dodge Challenger Hellcat right now. They don't care if it's a wide body. They don't care if it's a 21 or a 22. They happen to love either Black or Smoke Show. You got to share this video with them. Let them know these are two available Challenger Hellcats for sale today. And this is, we're at May 1st right now. And as of May 1st, they are available today. So, can't break any promises if you watch this video a week later or a month later, but definitely, if anything else, you've got to enjoy this RAL Hellcat walk around. So definitely share the video with everyone. You know, I truly would appreciate it. Last but not least, if you haven't already subscribed, please subscribe to the channel. Please subscribe. I truly would appreciate it. Getting very close to 1,000 subscribers. Getting very, 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 very close to 1,000 subscribers. We are looking forward to hitting that milestone. We are right now at 970 subscribers at the time of the recording of this video. And I want to thank each and every one of my OG subscribers. Thank you for supporting the channel. Thank you for being part of the family. But if you haven't already subscribed, if you're not part of the family yet, please subscribe. Subscribe and join the family. We have more great RAL Hellcat content coming in the year 2022. We have the Dodge Durango Hellcat featured in my channel. We have the Jeep Grand Cherokee Trackhawk featured on my channel. We have RAL Hellcat reviews, RAL Hellcat walking around, car shows, drag racing, more shenanigans, more fun, and then, of course, more features like the Chief Donut Maker competition and the Chief Donut Maker, I guess, travels and tribulations of Preston, who's now Dodge's Chief Donut Maker. So with all that being said, please like, comment, share, and subscribe. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope you enjoy the rest of your day. I hope it's a gorgeous day like it is in New Jersey right now. Blue skies, sunny, gorgeous out. The weather here is great. Hope the weather is great where you are. Again, thank you again for watching. I truly do appreciate it. Also, be safe out there. Be safe. And last but not least, please, peace to all of you. Peace to all of you. Not just in the United States, but all around the world. We want peace everywhere, including all the war that's going on in Ukraine. Peace to Ukraine. Peace to the United States. Peace to all of you. And you know how we end these videos. We always end these videos with a peace out. So that's nothing. Nothing's going to change here. Let's do it. Let's do the peace out. And we always do it. We always do it SRT mush style. So let's go. Here we go. Peace. Thanks again for watching. Enjoy the rest of your day. Be safe out there. Be safe. Peace to all of you. And we'll catch you. On the next video. So then again, we already know what the next video is going to be, because I promised Sansone, Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, Ram for their videos to come out and come out quickly. We just did the Dodge Challenger Hellcat walk around. We're now going to do their Jeep Grand Cherokee Trackhawk walk around. That's going to be the next video coming up. And then, of course, we will catch you on other walk around videos in the not too distant future. So definitely have to check those out. So with all that being said, we're going to do one last peace out to close this video. And here we go. 1, 2, 3. Here we go. Thanks again for watching. Enjoy the rest of your day. Peace. Catch you on the next video. Peace.
What happens when performance meets power? You try crazy things. Because you're crazy and you like it. You spend unhealthy amounts of manpower creating ungodly amounts of horsepower. You get bigger, badder, faster. You can never have too much of a good thing. And power is a very good thing.